vehicle racing, they did not put that engine in a small car to get a very favorable weight horsepower ratio. Instead, they put it in the biggest car you could find, a Mercedes S-Class, a red Mercedes S-Class, and thereby the motor sound was poor. And you have to admit, an S-Class with fender flares, with roll cage, with an open exhaust, with racing tires, that is just absolutely cool. And it was totally new. And it wasn't just cool, it was incredibly successful on the racetrack. For example, in 1971, the Rotesau won the 24 Hours of Le Mans, won its class, and came in second overall, thereby beating quite a lot of purpose designs, specifically designed race car and sports cars, doing incredibly well. And after that, you know, as they say, the rest is history, and today we can celebrate 50 years of AMG. By the way, we have many of the cars here that actually made AMG great over these 50 years. They just mentioned Rotesau is back there. We have the Hammer there. We have a legendary CLK GTR there. And we also have some of our most successful AMG cars of today outside available for customers to test drive. And for those of you who actually be going to the Quail tomorrow, we have a special car at the Quail, a car that we showed first time this year at the New York Auto Show, the X290. And this car is absolutely drop-dead gorgeous. It's going to be in our showrooms later this year, going strong and receiving fantastic feedback from the press. And today, 50 years after the Rotesau, it's my pleasure to tell everybody that behind the success of Mercedes in the marketplace, a big piece of that is owned by AMG. The colleagues have done a fantastic job, made AMG an integral part of the success that we have in the marketplace. Well done. Now, those of you who were here last year might also remember we showed you the Mercedes Vision Maybach 6, an absolute beautiful car. This year, 50 years of AMG, we wanted to show you something that really showcases what AMG is all about. And that, of course, is success on the racetrack. For the last 3 years, many of you know that probably, our Mercedes AMG Petronas Formula One race team has been absolutely dominating on the racetrack. The last 3 years, we won both the Drivers' Championship as well as the Constructors' Championship by a wide margin. And in the core of it all is the AMG power train. So the colleagues at AMG followed an old tradition to celebrate 50 years of AMG. After you win on Sunday, you take the winning formula and bring it to the showroom, bring it to the customers on Monday. Last year, as mentioned, it was about the Maybach Vision 6, about the beauty. This year, it's all about the beast under the sheet metal. Now, to tell you more about what Mercedes calls Project One, I want to introduce to you the man who drives AMG to the highest performance, both on the racetrack as well as in the show. Please welcome the president and CEO of Mercedes AMG, Tobias
Nuss. Thank you very much for that kind introduction and welcome here at Pebble. And it's up to me to present you a little bit later on all about technology in our Project One. But first of all, as Dima mentioned, these both guys started AMG off 50 years ago, and the brand was kind of founded in 50 years ago, but it was born on the racetrack in Spa, as Dima mentioned as well. Today, it's all about the success story of the company. It's 3 times in a row of 40% growth rate per year by year, in sales numbers. And still this year, we are more than happy with what we can see so far. So we still run at double-digit growth rate in our sales volume overall. We are moving up to more than 400 performance centers where we have the dedication for all of you, of our clients, of our customers, in the sales showrooms, in the sales showrooms, and together with our trained people, we are working because we train everybody who works in our performance center, dedicated about what's about AMG, the brand, and the technology and the cars. So, as well as racing, we are very successful with our GT3 racing, and as we start now, is GT4. Our new GT4 race car is going to do its debut that weekend at the VLN race at the Nürburgring, which is the most important proof point for a car like that. It's all about engines at Mercedes AMG. That's where it all started, and Mr. Alfred and Mr. Maker, they were really good engine guys. And it's all about being more efficient and being more powerful. This is the key for us in the performance segment. And it's all about being more efficient now. So we moved our engines down to 4-liter. Now we recently introduced our S-Class 4-liter engine for S63, a new one with a 4-liter engine. And it's all about as well transfer from motorsport to series production cars and series production engines. So we learned that a lot together with our colleagues and this is the Mercedes-Benz and Mercedes-AMG high-performance powertrain plant where we do the Mercedes Formula One engines. We work together with these guys and new technologies regarding turbochargers and simulation methodologies and things like that. But coming back to another point, we introduced from series production to race engine as well technologies like NanoSlide. This is kind of a process where we reduce friction between pistons and the ball lining that the crank comes. This is very important. And we started off with that in series production engines and introduced that to the race engine in 2014. Together with our colleagues in Brixton and Brackley, we're working on other technologies like cylinder shaft system, like cylinder deactivation system, which gives us additional efficiency, for example, in the E63 or an S63, which is the key, as I mentioned before, moving up with efficiency and additional power performance. When we do a review of what we achieved in the last years, we did our SLS electric drive as well, the so-called SLS E7. So far, it was the most performing AMG that we ever did. It was 750 horsepower with four individual, with individual electric motors and a range of more than 250 kilometers. And the battery was done together with our colleagues in Brixton because having a Formula One car, which is a performance hybrid car, using battery know-how and cell know-how, cooling know-how for batteries. Together with these guys, we developed the battery for that SLS electric drive. Knowing everything about performance car, knowing everything about the key for the future, because electrification is going to be the key for us for the future. Yeah? Because in the performance segment, you have to increase performance as well as efficiency. So hybridization and electrification is going to be the key for us in the future. As we showed this year in Geneva with our GT concept car, Dietmar mentioned it, we're going to show that, we're going to show you that car tomorrow at the Quay. It's the first plug-in hybrid, performance plug-in hybrid AMG ever did and ever layout. It's a show car as of today, but I can be pretty sure that we're going to bring that to market soon. Not this year, but maybe next year. And have a look to the video. load it at the end, or we combine in that car with an electric hybrid architecture system solution on the rear axle. So that we have more power, we have more performance. My expectation is we are very good at acceleration as of today, 0 to 60 miles per hour in an E63, for example, 3.4 seconds. This car is going to be even faster than that. It's all about keeping driving dynamics, moving ahead with driving dynamics. It's all about driving performance, which is our brand core. It's all about being more efficient and having more performance. The car we showed, and you're going to see it tomorrow, the coil has a combined power output of more than 800 horsepower.
Wow.
Knowing all about that, and you can imagine AMG is not a company putting a show car in Geneva on the stage not knowing how it's going to work. Putting all our know-how together, that could be the portfolio for the future in the RGB family. Putting all know-how together with our colleagues in Gregory Blackley, which are the Formula One car guys, and Bricksworth, which are the Formula One engine guys, and our know-how, our knowledge, our competency about performance cars which we gained over the last 50 years, the core and the heart of our Project One is a really extraordinary drivetrain. So, have a look.
Compressor and turbine, you do have an electric motor with additional
kilowatts. This revs up the turbocharger, so the charge response of that engine is better than every V8 natural aspirator, promise you. And it recovers the energy when you break the car down, when you break it full cornering, it recovers the energy back to the battery. As well, near at the crankshaft, another electric motor with 120 kilowatts, which increases the revs and pushes the combustion engines to higher revs. And it's all the combination. So the combined power output of the whole car is more than 1,000 horsepower. We do have additional electric motors at the front axle. It's an all-wheel drive. So we have front axle, which is really linked to our SLS electric drive, where we did have four individual electric motors. We do have an electric front axle where we have the same electric motors, and that's the electric motors out of Formula One car as well. We use on the front axle wheel individual, 120 kilowatt individual per wheel, which gives us another advantage regarding drive dynamics, regarding torque breakthrough. Then we have a dedicated battery as well. A battery we use the cell technology out of the Formula One car with four times more of capacity. With that electric front axle and the capacity out of that battery, the car is able to run maybe close to 30 kilometers purely electric driven. So in my perspective, that's the most performing and most modern hypercar you can get